Good evening, everyone. It's Saturday, September the 23rd. The time is 8:10 p.m. and the temperature is around 21 degrees Celsius. And I'm walking south along Bay Street. And today is the Nuit, Blanche Art Festival that's taking place in downtown Toronto on a Saturday evening. So I thought I would check it out. And it's going to be an exciting event as Nuit Blanche returns this weekend. So now I'm walking south towards Queen Street West. And coming up on the right will be Nathan Phillips Square. So Nuit Blanche means white night in French, and Nuit Blanche is where people display their arts on the street for us to take a look. So it's one of the art festivals. So this is Albert Street. And just look east along Albert Street towards the Toronto Union Centre Shopping Mall. And as you can see, along this stretch of Bay Street, it's starting to get packed as we walk towards Queen Street West. Not sure if the camera is picking up, but there seems to be like a performance going on. Well, I can't really see it from here, as there's a big crowd of people. I guess maybe we'll come back. I'll just stick around this side for now. So this is the intersection of Queen Street West and Bay Street. Maybe in a few minutes I'll come back to Nathan Phillips Square, but for now I want to continue south along Bay Street. So now we're crossing Queen Street West. And I'll be looking east. So here we go. Welcome to Nuit Blanche event. Very interesting. So now we're crossing Richmond Street West, and that'll be looking east along Richmond. So this event began an hour ago, and the Nuit Blanche runs from 7 p.m. till 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. And the good news is, the subway is open all midnight for Nuit Blanche. During midnight from 1:30 a.m. till around 8 o'clock. So this is Adelaide Street West. And it's actually my first time recording a video at Nuit Blanche, because unfortunately last year I did not get a chance to check out Nuit Blanche. So today is my chance. And we're crossing Adelaide Street West.
Are they coming back? Are they coming back? Are we well? Meeting in the
Let's look back north, up along Bay Street towards Queen Street West, which is by Nathan Phillips Square.
Mm-hmm.
So once again, welcome to Nuit, Blanche. So now we're about to enter the financial district. Oh, and just on the left is the food trucks. There's tacos, and there is poutine and more. Oh, and there's the old City Hall at the corner of Queen and Bay, and that we're looking back north.
What do you want, cinnamon?
Sorry.
Jesus Christ. Oh, now my screen's all
crooked. All right, so this is King Street West. So welcome to the financial district. So right now I'm at the corner of King Street West and Bay Street. And there goes the 504 King that will make its way all the way west to Rossesvilles. So as you can see, a lot of people are having a great time here at Nuit Blanche in downtown Toronto by the financial district. And so far, I'm not hearing any music playing. That's good. I don't have to worry about picking up a copyright match music. All right, so there's Wellington Street West coming up. Thank you.
stop to take it out. Hold me.
So this is Wellington and Bay. And now we're looking east. All right, so I'll continue south up to Front Street West, and then I'll head back north to Nathan Phillips Square.
Wasn't gonna, you know.
Oh, and there is Tinny Tom Donuts. Alright, so here we are at Front and Bay in the Financial District, and just on the right will be Union Station. And there is the amazing view of the CN Tower at night, the Canadian National Tower. Look at all the traffic along Front and Bay. Again, this is why I try to avoid driving downtown. Because you know me, I hate getting stuck in traffic. Especially on a Saturday evening, close to nighttime. So continuing south along Bay will lead you to Queens Quay West, which is by Queens Quay Station Ferry Docks, also known as Ferry Docks. Here is one last look up the CN Tower before we head back north to Nathan Phillips Square. Alright, so now I'm going to be making my way back north to Nathan Phillips Square to see what's going on over there. So goodbye, Front Street West. Oh, and there's the food from East Truck. there is poutine. I remember trying one of these poutines from a food truck, and I have to say, their poutine is so good. I've tried poutine many times. And we're back at Wellington Street West. And there's look west up along Wellington towards University Avenue. Ooh, nice. Oh, there's Shine. There's even Shine Foundation. Ooh, it's dark over here. I don't know why they don't add any more street lights along the stretch. I mean they have a few, but all of a sudden, like, around from where I am, got a little bit dark for some reason, but oh well. So now we're back at King and Bay, which is still in the financial district. So this building here is First Canadian Place, and that's where Johnny Strides used to work at. Who is also a Toronto YouTuber as well. There goes the eastbound King streetcar. Oh, it stopped because the light turned red. So there's the 504 King number 4520 that will make its way east. All the way to I think Church Street. Yeah, because it says short turning to Church. I was right. There goes the eastbound streetcar once again. And there goes the 51B Queen replacement bus service. Number 8205. So here's one as the quest up along King Street towards York Street and towards University Avenue by St. Andrew Station. And that must be the 503 Kingston Road replacement bus service that will make its way eastbound all the way to Victoria Park Avenue. So far, I'm having a great time at Nuit Blanche on a Saturday evening, or should I say Saturday night, as the time is 8:38 p.m. So I might stay at the Nuit Blanche until maybe around 11 o'clock, or maybe 10, who knows? There's the Nova LFS bus, route 503 Kingston Road. And here's a look back south, up along Bay towards Front Street West. So now we're about to leave the financial district. And we're back at the food trucks, and there's Tiny Tom Donuts. There's a huge lineup for poutine. And there's tacos. Ooh, they even have Cheerios. Sorry.
Make it easy.
All right, now we're back at Adelaide Street West. So we're almost close to Nathan Phillips Square.
Thank you.
Oh, so far, the music was very peaceful. This is Richmond Street West. And there is Old City Hall. Just straight ahead. Well, this car just blocked the intersection. And it's getting packed here. Very packed. Oh yes, welcome to downtown Toronto on a busy Saturday evening during Nuit Blanche. And we're back at Queen Street West. And there's Old City Hall once again. Alright, so now I'm on Queen Street West, so I'll be checking out Nathan Phillips Square. But while I'm on Queen Street West, maybe I'll take a walk along this stretch for now and to see what it's like. So along this stretch, we got lots of open space where people can walk on. So this is where, along this stretch, are doing, this is where they're doing the construction for the Ontario line, which again will take at least 4.5 years. And there is Nathan Phillips Square on the right. and I look back east towards Bay Street. So welcome to Nathan Phillips Square. And here we go. Here's the Toronto sign that I'm capturing, and this is City Hall. So as you can see, Nathan Phillips Square is starting to get packed on a Saturday evening because of Nuit Blanche. It's getting dark here from where I'm walking. And yes, welcome to Nathan Phillips Square during Nuit Blanche. There's the Toronto sign once again. Thank you. Ooh, look at that. Interesting. Oh, sorry.
Oh yeah, that is.
All right, so now it's been almost 50 minutes that I've been recording this video of Nuit Blanche, and so far I'm having a great time on a Saturday night. Oh, and that was the clock tower for 9 o'clock. Oh, and there's lots to see at Mayfield Square. All the pennies, all the coins as well. To me, they look like pennies to me, if I'm mistaken, or I could be wrong. Those round things, small round things, whatever you call them. Oh, look at that. They're like footprints to me. Let's continue on. All right, so going to be making my way up the steps to the second level. of the square, because I do want to, because I do want to find a good spot to end my video, because it's been almost an hour, and now it's been 53 minutes that I've been recording this video. Oh, there's Hero certified burgers.
You never looked up the whole pack.
What's that like?
All right, let's capture the waterfall once again. And here is the Toronto sign, which looks very cool at night. So once again, here's the view of Nathan Phillips Square, which is starting to get really, really, really packed during Nuit Blanche. I know I've said it a few times. So the time right now is 9:04 p.m. and this event began 2 hours ago. And Nuit Blanche ends tomorrow morning at 7 o'clock. Alright, so now I gotta find my way up the steps. And we got crowds of people at the square, but no worries. I'm always aware of crowds when it comes to these events, like Nuit Blanche, for example. And of course, Nuit Blanche is one of the art festivities as well. Alright, I'm gonna make my way up the steps to the second level. And here we go. Thank you. Oh, I love the Toronto sign at night. So beautiful with different colors. Well, it's a green sign with the Toronto sign. And later on, it will change colors. Now it's blue. Before it was green, now it's... Oh, actually, it's light blue. And it will keep changing colors every few minutes. How nice. As you can see, we got lots of people taking videos and pictures of the Toronto sign at night during the Nuit, Blanche art festival. But I was so glad that I was able to check out Nuit, Blanche for the very first time since I wasn't able to check out the Nuit, Blanche last year. Because I felt a bit lazy and felt tired back then, but thank God I am so energized that I get to come here at night in downtown Toronto, especially at Nathan Phillips Square, to check out Nuit Blanche and of course the amazing view of the Toronto sign. And now the color turned green. I wonder if the sign will turn yellow, but we'll see. It did turn blue before, now it's green, so... But how nice. And just look south towards Queen Street West. Check this out. It's one of the amazing Art cultures. So far it's been a fun tour around downtown Toronto during Nuit Blanche. I'm just making sure I've captured everything that I see before I end this video. So welcome to Nathan Phillips Square on a busy Saturday night during Nuit Blanche. But anyways folks, now that it's been almost an hour, I think I'm going to be ending this video. So I want to thank you all so much for watching, and don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe and all that fun stuff. And we've explored around Nuit Blanche, and we've started off at Bay Street, just a bit south of Dundas, and we walked south along Bay from Dundas to Front Street West, and we checked out all the Nuit Blanche art festivities, or festivities, sorry for my mispronunciation. And we also walked back north on Bay from Front to Queen, and we also toured around Nathan Phillips Square, checking out all the art displays that was available. So if you enjoyed this one, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. It's called Sepan TTC Explorer. And of course, if you wish to see more upcoming videos from me, don't forget to click the bell notification bell, so that way you don't miss any of my upcoming videos for the future. And I have an Instagram account at Sepan TTC Explorer, the same name as my YouTube channel name. So feel free to follow me on that as well if you wish. Time right now is 9:15 p.m. So it's been an hour that I've been recording this video, this night walk, where I explored around Nuit Blanche on a Saturday night. So maybe I'll just stay around for a bit until around, I would say, 10:30 or 11 o'clock, and then after that I'll hop on the subway and head back home. So again, the subway runs all midnight from 1:30 a.m. till around 8 o'clock in the morning, until regular service resumes. And yeah, so I hope you guys enjoy the rest of your weekend, and you know, stay safe wherever you travel to, and I will see you guys very soon in my next video. Take care and bye bye. And cheers.